Hello friends, welcome to Study Tricks. Today we shall see some details regarding Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Abhiyan. Before going into the scheme, we shall see how the hospital infrastructure is organized in our country. Many of you might know what is a primary healthcare center, a secondary healthcare center and a tertiary healthcare center. Let us have a quick view of the definitions of primary healthcare, secondary healthcare and tertiary healthcare units. Primary healthcare is one such which is normally located at village level and small town levels. These are concerned about health problems and methods of identifying, preventing and controlling them. Auxiliary nurses, midwives are the very first persons who are providing this primary health care. This primary health care centers play a vital role in rural areas. Coming to a secondary health care center, these are those hospitals which have better facilities, like those hospitals which can have an X-ray machinery, ECG machinery. Probably they will be present in district hospitals. Coming to tertiary health care units, these are the hospitals which have the advanced equipments like super speciality hospitals. These are mostly available in metropolitan cities. These are the three healthcare units present in Indian society. Coming to the accounts of health sector, we can see that the current expenditure is almost 93% in the total health expenditure. This is according to 2013 and 14. In this 93%, again 72.9% of health expenditure is coming from only households. That means we can see that out of pocket expenditure is increasing. What is this out-of-pocket expenditure? This is the amount of money that a person puts from his pocket excessively. This percentage has been increasing in the Indian society. This is because of many reasons. Let us have a look of those reasons. First of all, this high percentage of out-of-pocket expenditure is pushing many families into below poverty line. 4 to 7% of households went to poverty because of out-of-pocket expenditure during 2004-14 duration. That means if you observe in simple calculations, out of every 10 rupees, 4 rupees is going to only medicines. Out of 10 rupees spent on healthcare, if you are spending 4 towards only your medicine, what about the remaining expenses? This is pushing nearly 30 to 35 million people into poverty. This is also the loophole of Indian healthcare system. These are all the ground realities of today as far as healthcare is concerned in India. Coming to investments. Investments in preventive healthcare is very low. What is preventive healthcare? Before a disease attacking a mass of people, the measures that we take to prevent such care is known as preventive health care. This investment in preventive health care is very much low. And coming to infrastructure in government hospitals, first of all, the infrastructure itself is not adequate. And even if you have infrastructure, it is maintained in a very poor condition. Overall, government hospitals are like hospitals of poor people. They have become like that because only people below poverty line or middle class people has been visiting government hospitals. The remaining population has been visiting only private hospitals which are charging very high prices. And coming to tertiary care, even you are poor, tertiary care people generally prefer only private hospitals which are in metropolitan cities. You can clearly understand how a poor family suffers if he has to go to a tertiary care hospital which is situated in a nearby city. 11.3% of registered allopathic doctors are working in public sector. You can see how less the ratio is. 11.3% itself is working in public sector. Then what about the remaining doctors? Obviously, they are working in the private sector. At present, if you see the overall analysis of private and public sector doctors, 60 to 70% of patients, both out care and in care, that is outpatient care and inpatient treatments, are in private sector only. That means only 30% is in public sector. Then here comes the biggest question of accountability. How private sector hospitals are accountable? Coming to the other issue of Indian society is, on an average, if you observe, 22,000 rupees is being spent by a normal family on healthcare. Then, in such case, imagine if at all a poor family has diseases like cancer, organ failures, etc. Their life becomes chaos. That means Indian families are spending 22,000 on hospitalization itself, that too in private hospitals. This is the reality of Indian healthcare. What are the main reasons why Indian healthcare system is so poor is, we are mainly facing these three biggest burdens. The very first one is, we have an unfinished agenda of eradicating communicable diseases. We have been struggling to eradicate these communicable diseases, but even today, our agenda of completely eradicating communicable diseases is not finished. And we are seeing more and more number of non-communicable diseases increasing. And the road accidents are also biggest burden in India. If you observe the analytics, non-communicable diseases and traffic deaths are costing nearly 6.5% of GDP in India. Under such circumstances, Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Abhiyan has come. What are the features of this Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Abhiyan? This is going to cover 10 crore families. These families belong to poor and vulnerable population. How we are going to identify who are the people who are coming under poor and vulnerable population are based on SECC database, socio-economic caste census database. What is this socio-economic caste census? In this, there will be census in which their socio-economic conditions are noted. Depending upon this database, there are nearly 8.03 crore people in rural area and 2.33 crore people in urban area. These are those people who are going to be covered under Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Abhiyan. It is going to cover rupees 5 lakh per family per annum. And it is going to cover almost all secondary and most tertiary care procedures. You should note this, no primary care comes under this Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Abhiyan. All secondary and most tertiary care procedures comes under this. And Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Abhiyan is going to subsume the ongoing centrally sponsored schemes. What is this centrally sponsored schemes? These are those schemes which are sponsored by the central government, like Rashtriya Swasthya Bima Yojana and Senior Citizen Health Insurance Scheme. These two are also subsumed under Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Abhiyan. And there is no cap on the family size. It can be large, small. There is no cap on the number of family persons and age. There is no cap on the age also. And it includes pre and post hospitalization expenses. And a defined transport alliance is also provided to the beneficiary. And these benefits are portable across the country. One of the best points regarding this scheme is this feature. Portable across this country is, for example, if a worker who has migrated from Bihar to some southern state has been facing some health issue. Till now, there were no pan-India programs as far as healthcare sector was seen. But with this scheme, the person from any state can get treatment in any other state under Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Abhiyan. And the beneficiary is allowed to take cashless benefits in public and empaneled private hospitals. That means he can go to any public hospital and get the beneficiary, and he can go to the empaneled private hospitals and get his service done. And what is this empanelment of private hospitals? Some of the private hospitals are given this empanelment. This empanelment is given on certain criteria which we will be seeing. And to control the payments, like if a private hospital is given this, the private hospital also has some rules. That is, it has some rules to control the cost and payment of treatment. These are as per the cost associated with the package treatment only. And for beneficiaries, it will be complete cashless and paperless transaction. This scheme, Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Abhiyan, was launched on September 25th to commemorate the birth anniversary of Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay. In the first, I have said that nearly 8.03 crore people from rural area and 2.33 crore in urban area are covered under this scheme. And what are those 8.33 people and what are their backgrounds is, in rural area, there are certain occupations which are automatically included into this program. This inclusion of certain people is automatic. Those are listed here, like households without shelter, primitive tribal groups, etc. And in urban areas, there are 11 defined occupational categories. Depending upon these occupational categories, they are entitled under the scheme. Now, in this scheme, what is the role of states? That means, what is the flexibility given to individual state and all, we will be seeing in the next session. Until then, stay tuned to Study Tricks for more such videos. Please like, share and subscribe the video so that we come up with such a wonderful content. Thank you.